Then.
Yeah, Lauren, are you ready? Yeah, we started recording here, but you're ready. Okay, Pranav's ready, everyone's ready. 3, 2, 1.
Hello, I'm Nishan, and the first method we can use to measure the height of a building is a physics constant. We use the acceleration formula, which is A equals to V minus U over T. And then we write the whole equation with V in terms of A, U and T.
Hi, I'm Nafis. As we know, velocity is equal to U plus AT. Then we integrate velocity, we get displacement, whereas S is equal to UT plus half AT square plus C. Then how about the C?
So based on the equation we have just integrated, we can assume that T equals to 0 and the displacement is also 0, therefore C is also equal to 0.
Hi, my name is Sohui. After collecting the experiment 3 million times, we managed to get an average reading of 2.73 seconds. Since the initial velocity of the ball is 0 meter per second and acceleration is 10 meter per second squared due to gravity, S equals 0 times 2.73 plus half times 10 times 2.73 squared. Therefore, the displacement equals to 37.26 meters.
Okay, so today we are going to talk about the trigonometric method. So the trigonometric method is based on a triangle, like this triangle. So at first we found the length of the base by using a measuring tape. And we found the angle by using a projector, which we print out the picture of the building and we draw a triangle on it.
Hi, I'm Samuel. So tangent 65.9 equals to the height of the building divided by 16.06 meters. So we move up the 16.06 meters towards the tangent 65.9. We got a height of the building of 35.9 meters.
The third method we use to measure the height of the building is the pencil method. In this method, we hold the pencil upright and align the top of the pencil to the top of the building and the bottom of the pencil to the bottom of the building. And then after that, we turn the pencil horizontally and to make it parallel to the ground. Then we mark the tip of the pencil. Then we calculate the distance between the bottom of the pencil to the tip of the pencil. And that's the height of the building.
Okay, so you know for the physics experiment, right?
No.
Okay, but the physics concept, our time was really off. Like, it made the building 40 meters and it should be about 30 something. And I think that's because of air resistance against the wall that's going downwards. Right? Yeah.
That's not about it. I think there's also one more problem, which is the connection. Like, when you call someone above to the bottom, like, it's gonna take time.
for the signal.
Why use DG?
I think that was a delay also, like the timer and the ball didn't drop at the same time. That's why the feeling like seems taller after the calculating.
Yeah, to me, win also one of the cause. You know, when I'm dropping the ball hits the wall. Oh, it's because of the win.
Which ball? The tennis ball or your ball?
Dude, okay.
Basketball.
Basketball. Yeah, basketball. So it probably increased the distance, right?
Yeah,
so that would have increased the height of the building.
So what about the, that's for physics, right? What about the trigonometric method?
Oh yeah, when I was taking the picture, right, I noticed that the building was staggered. So like the further back parts of the building were like seem higher.
Oh.
Yeah, so it's like the image was distorted because of the perspective.
Yeah, and also
you clean the picture, it's only in A4 size and our pen is too thick to draw the line, so
I think it's not that accurate.
But I mean, I think we tried our best because if we took a big, let's say a bigger object, there'll be more resistance. We took something reasonably small, even the signal, right, the delay, it's like so little compared to the sound delay if we shouted from the top of the building.
So
we did try and minimize everything as much as possible.
We did our best.
What if we tried to measure a mountain? Could we do that with the same methods?
I think trigo is not practical. Yeah, not practical.
Yeah, physics also. You cannot climb the mountain.
You can't drop something from the top of the mountain.
Or but you can take a helicopter, what? I mean, just fly there.
Level the mountain with the helicopter.
Right, yeah.
But it'd be really noisy, right? You can't use a phone.
Logical.
And also, think of it, a mountain is so high, and you drop a ball, and that ball is under there, and you have no idea where that ball is going to drop. But I guess if there was just like a clean padang and you drop the ball in Kerala.
What's padang here?
So padang is 50.
But you can't drop padang, right?
Down there. Oh, that's our cameraman at the bottom floor.
Yeah.
Zhonghui!